thank you for watching this broadcast.
Alright, so we're going to continue with part 2 of this tutorial, and let's see what we got so far. This is what we got so far. We can move back and forth, and we can punch. And so today we're going to import our enemy sprites, and we are going to get our enemy to move. Actually, we're going to get the enemy to follow him. So that's coming up next in the Spark My Channel. Now, if you don't have these sprites, you can find them under the description below. Actually, let me just show you the folder. The link under the description below will take you to Spark Drive. Okay, you can download these sprites. All you have to do is click this button and you can download them. It's in a zip format. You're going to need a WinZip or WinRAR. I believe Windows can unzip too. Okay, let's go back to Construct. And as I mentioned, this is what we got so far. We can punch and walk. So let's import our bad guy. Let's insert a new object in the sprite. And let's begin importing his bad one. Let's call this animation stop. Let's make a new animation. And let's call this walking. Let's import the sprites. 2 frames. Let's set the animation speed to 6. Loop the animation. Close this. And there is our bad guy. Now if you run this, you're going to notice that nothing happens. How come? Yeah. Let's close this. Let's insert the background. Tile background. Make it any color. Purple. I'll make everything purple. I don't know why. Let's give our bad guy a behavior. Behaviors. Platform object. Scroll down and let's disable his default controller. Run this. That works fine. Let's make this a solid object. Behaviors. Solid. And that works fine. Now we can make this invisible if you wanted to. Disable visible. There we go. Let me save this. It's always a good practice to always save your project. So, let's add one more behavior to our bad guy. Add behavior. And we want line of sight. Okay. Again, if you run this, you will notice that nothing happens. Alright, so let's right click on the bad guy. And let's add a variable. We want this to be a number. And just to make this simple, let's call this HH. We start this at 0, go to events. And if that variable is 0 compared to variable, it has equal 0. Then we can move our object. Then we're going to move our object to the right. Try it out. Oops. I think I went left. Did I go left? Oh, that's right, actually. I meant to go left. Okay, maybe he walks a little too fast. He should walk a little slower. Maximum speed. Maybe we can set this to 80. And the acceleration to maybe 2000. Deacceleration, super fast too. Try it out. And that's much better. Okay, so back to events. Let me just copy this. Set this at 1. And if you set to 1, we want him to move right. That works fine. But you notice that he doesn't notice our character. All right. Add a new event. If our character's X position compared to X, it's say less than Sprite 2, which is our bad guy. Maybe I should label that. Let me just label that first before we do this. Just call him bad, and we're gonna call him something simple like good versus evil. I should call him evil instead. All right, back to events. Add a new event. We're gonna compare the X position of good. Should we call him Bab? Okay. If it's less than the X position of bad that that X, you can see it's just like Game Maker. You can also go to find expression and you probably find the same thing there. So if this happens, we want the this variable to change. Say variable HH, we're gonna set it to 1. Try it out. Oh, wait a second. We did that backwards. It should be greater. Okay. And that seems to work fine. Let me just copy this and invert it. Less than. Then we can set the number back to 0. There you go. Now, if you were coding this by hand, this will be the exact same thing you will have to do. Okay. Visual scripting, it's a good idea if you want to get into programming. But yeah, why bother when everything is already here? Okay, so let's see. So that works fine. So now we just need to change the animation. So if it's 0, we can change the animation to walking animation, set animation. Walking, and when it's equals 1, actually let me just copy this and paste it over here. Okay, try it out. There we go. That works fine. He needs to turn around. Add action. We want him to mirror or to turn around. See if that works. That works fine. We just need to do the reverse of that. You can simply copy this and paste it over here. Set mirror. Not mirrored. Try it out. That works fine. Okay. So let me put them over here. And my character over here. Let's adjust the line of sight. Let's set this at to super short, maybe 3000. Now line 6 is only going to work if our character is in the line of sight. So let's right click and let's add a new event. Another condition. The character has to be in the line of sight. And the character is good. Okay. Let me copy this. Paste it. Try it out. Okay, maybe he needs to change his line of sight to super short. Okay, 20 is a little too much. Okay. Let's see. Try 100. Okay, maybe that's too little. Try 500. Try 300. 400. There we go. Now it works. And he follows our character. Now when he's in range, he should stop. Okay, now he doesn't. He just goes crazy. Let's add a new event. Collision. Collision with another object. And if that happens, we're going to change his variable to 2. Try it. And that kind of works. I think this should be overlap. Let me just replace this for overlapping. See what happens. There we go, that works. So we want to change the animation to change the animation. I'll set it to stop. Now later we can change it to start punching or something, or attacking. For now he just stops. Okay, his deacceleration is a little too much. So we also want to set his acceleration to 0. There we go. Yeah, so let's set the acceleration back to normal here. Maybe, what was it initially? I think it's 100. Copy it. It's another copy. Try it again. And that works not too bad. Alright, so in the next tutorial we are going to make our character actually punch the bad guy. Also don't forget that there is a bell next to the subscribe button. Yeah, don't forget to click the bell. Now when you click the bell, YouTube will let you know when the next video comes out. The community tab. Okay, this is the community tab right here. Click on it and you will see other stuff. Okay guys, thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye now.